I think we've said it once, but I'm going to say it again anyway. This is the Cardinal Singers behind me. This is a group of students between 6th grade and 12th grade, and we're from Redbird Christian School. That's in southeastern Kentucky, about as far from nowhere as you can get. We're a small Christian school with 160 students, K through 12. And we don't want this to be the Redbird Cardinal Singers show. We're here to worship with you, so we invite you to, if you know the songs, sing right along with us, all right? And we've got a couple extra instruments if you want to come on up.
Hey, Leo, you got to get the dulcimer going later after.
He already learned the banjo. We got him going on it.
Hey, I
got to
ask, the girls in the back, is there
any way that you can get them TVs in the back to show what this is showing or not? If that's possible, we would probably feel really more comfortable because we depend on that more than we realize. They looked at me, they were going, and I'm giving them little signs. This is your mind, this is your heart, this is your strength, okay? Good to get those in order right there. All right. They did good, they did good.
All right, this is marvelous, marvelous song. Uh-oh.
This piano don't have those notes. Let me go up here. Four pages at once. It really did not work at all. So let's
sing to the Lord a marvelous song. A marvelous, 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 marvelous song. Sing to the Lord a marvelous song. A marvelous, 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 marvelous song.
This is another worship song called I Will Magnify. You please watch us with our motions, and then we'd like you to join in after you hear it one time. All right.
Ready?
Go.
I will magnify. I lift your name on high. You, oh Lord alone, are worthy of praise. I will magnify. I lift your name on high. You, the Lord alone, are worthy of praise.
Okay, you got it? All right, let's try it together. Hey, look at me, look at me. We use our hands for a lot of things. Sometimes we use our hands for the wrong things. But tonight, I would like you to use your hands for Jesus. Please, give them to him. Ready? Go.
I will magnify. I lift your name on high. You, oh Lord alone, are worthy of praise. I will magnify. I lift your name on high. You, oh Lord alone, are worthy of praise.
Okay, now you have the echo. So the choir will be the echo with you. I lift you high.
You see how that works?
All right, it's coming fast. I lift you high.
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 I lift your name high. You, the Lord alone, are worthy of praise.
I lift you high.
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 I lift your name high. You, the Lord alone, are worthy of praise.
Hands.
I will magnify. I lift your name on high. You, oh Lord alone, are worthy of praise. I will magnify. I lift your name on high. You, oh Lord alone, are worthy of praise.
You,
you
are
worthy of praise.
I will lift your name on high. your name on high. You, oh Lord, alone are worthy of praise. I will magnify, I lift your name on high. You, oh Lord, alone are worthy of praise. I will magnify, I lift your name on high. You, oh Lord, alone are worthy of praise.
Okay, so every one of our students, we've asked them to write their faith story. And Haley said she would share hers with you tonight. So would you please welcome Haley?
Hi, everybody. My name is Haley. I'm 13 years old, and I play volleyball. I go to Redbird Christian School, and I am in eighth grade. I play varsity and middle school volleyball. I'm the oldest sibling of two sisters and one brother. I live with my grandma and my great-grandma because my mom lost custody of me due to active drug addiction. She was never at the house, and when she was, it wasn't long till she ended up in jail again. My dad, on the other hand, wasn't present in my life either. My family was very religious and taught me how to be. We went to church every Sunday until I was 8, and then I stopped going due to lack of faith. When I was 8, I tried to read the Bible and get close to Jesus again, but I stopped because it was boring. When I was 12, I transferred schools to Redbird, hoping to get a better relationship with God. I learned more about Jesus, and slowly my relationship with God grew, but it wasn't as close as I wanted it to be. I made choices that hurt myself and others, and I gave up on Christ until March 22nd, 2024. I went to a youth camp with my friends, and I got prayed for at the altar. That was the first time in my life I got touched by the Holy Spirit, and that experience changed my life forever. I'm going to leave you with one Bible verse, Hebrews 11:6. And without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is rewarder of those who seek him. I'm glad I got the privilege to share my testimony with you. I hope you learned something from this. Thank you for listening.
Okay, so I cleared this next song with preacher. He said we should be okay. We're from Southeast Kentucky. Now, Gabe told me he's a redneck, but he never seen redneck till he come to Redbird, okay? Gabe, I swear, if you come, you'll be right at home with us, okay? All right, so So when we get to heaven, I mean, I'm sure people's gonna rejoice and celebrate in different ways, but probably you'll see some of us doing this. Just make sure you know what's gonna what we're doing. We're happy, okay? We're happy. We're there, so it's coming down. Come on.
I have a home. Is it I have a home?
Yeah.
Wait, Leo, hang on. Leo, did you want to do this? You want me? Okay. I'll give it a shot. It was my second day.
I have a home prepared where the saints abide, just over in the glory land.
And I long to be by my Savior's side,
just over in the glory land.
Over.
might help you not to get your teeth off. I'm just saying, we don't have that kidney shirt.
Okay, all right.
Dancers, one, two, ready, go! Step, two, three, four, and back. Right arm swing. Left arm. Both hands. Do-si-do. Seesaw. Head couple fly.
Woo! Yeah.
See the sin box? All right, we don't like to show that when we come in the church because people get a little nervous. But it has a purpose. I just trust me, okay? Thank you.
been in the box, haven't we?
Jesus took me out.
The box. And, I mean, hey, boys, listen to me just a minute. Listen to me just a minute. Guys, I've been in that box. I'm not a good person. I'm not a good person. And Jesus doesn't ask us in the church to be good people. He died for people like me. And he said, I'll forgive you if you just ask me. But you cannot get out of the box. You cannot make your heart clean. No matter what you do, you could go to church every day. You could be nice to everybody you meet, but that does not clean my heart. I found out one day and I said, Lord, thank you for letting me know. Now, sometimes I know for myself, maybe I don't know about you, he's taken me out of that box and I climb back in that box. I'm not proud of that, but every time I find myself back in the box, I said, Lord, please take me back out. And guess what he did? He took me back out. And every day I'm trying, with his help, to stay out of that box, okay? And I know you know that story, but God, he wants to make sure everybody knows that. We love you. Thanks for letting us. Hey, Charlie. hey, he took me out of the box. It's nothing I could have done, right? So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for letting us share. I got another student wants to share their testimony tonight. So, Brianna, are you going to come up here? This is Brianna. She's a senior. She's got 3 weeks of school left, and then she's going to go to UK, University of Kentucky. All right, so here she is.
Hello.
Hi.
I hope everyone's doing well. My name is Brianna Couch. I'm a senior at Redbird Christian School. I'm 18 years old and have been attending Redbird for 4 years. Today I'm going to share my testimony with you. Growing up, I was always taught to believe in Christianity, and as a child, I had faith like no other. This began to change as I got older. At 6 years old, my mother placed me in a home with random people. To this day, I still have no idea what their names were, but I do remember the late nights and loud music I heard while in my bedroom. And I also remember the pain from the abuse that was being handed out, but I still had my faith. At 8 years old, I was placed in a home with my aunt. I had never known her before, but I will always remember the burst of excitement that I had when finding out that I would be going to stay with a family member. That excitement soon ended when I found out that this place was no better than the last. I vaguely remember screaming in pain at only 8 years old because I had been hit so hard, but I still had my faith. At 9 years old, I went home with my mother. The feeling I had when seeing my mom again was terrifying, but she was sober now. My mom done everything in her power to relieve me of the trauma I went through while she was gone. As I got older, she began to fall back into the worldly temptations and decided it was time to have her freedom again. She left my father and started a new life, only this time she decided to keep me in it. Her new boyfriend was no less than 300 pounds and at least 6'4", so you can imagine the pain that would be brought onto my mother and I when we soon found out how abusive he was. There was many terrifying events, but this one that I will never forget. He busted my mother's head through a glass table. She was taken to the hospital. At 12 years old, I had to drive my own mother to the hospital. She had to get stitches in her head, and I was by her side the entire time. I saw the pain that my mother was in and could not really understand why God was putting my mother and I through this, but I still kept my faith. Soon after this, I was placed in foster care. The lady that I lived with never put her hands on me, but mentally she destroyed me. I left her home after a year and went back home to my father. When telling people this story, many ask why I didn't go stay with my father from the start. This was because he was not my biological father. I have no idea who that is. But this man was at the hospital the day that I was born and never left my side after that. He went to court many times to get custody, but was never granted it because we had no blood relation. After a while, I was placed in foster care again because my mother was failing to show changes in her behavior. The lady I moved in with was rude and hateful. I was constantly walking on eggshells and mostly never left my room. And while this place was better than the last places I had been, I could not understand why I could not just catch a break. But I kept my faith. On March the 8th of 2021, I had court. I was told that I would be going to live with my father as he was going through the process of adoption for me. My father passed away on his way to court. My dad was my best friend. He never failed to give me any idea that I could not be whomever I pleased. He reminded me that I would do amazing things and would always make sure that I knew about Jesus. Every night when I was home, he would come into my bedroom and have a come to Jesus meeting. He would pray over me and tell me he loved me and good night. When I was moved out of his home, he FaceTimed me every night and continued to pray for me and tell me he loves me and good night. His passing genuinely broke me. I had no idea who I was without my father. I no longer had my faith. I was angry. I did not even want to look at a church house for months after his funeral. I was done with the worship and the praying, and at one point even believing. I got into terrible habits. If I was not high, I was asleep. I did not want to talk to anybody and refused to have a genuine relationship with anyone. A few months after my dad's passing, I was told that I would be moving into a new foster home. I was scared. Terrified would be the word. I lost my spot. Hold on. I'll get it. Give me just a second. At this point, I accepted things were never going to get better. I was so wrong. In September of 2020, I was placed with Jared and Allison Gray. I was bitter at first, but these people welcomed me into their home with open arms and a couple lectures. They were nice and loving. There was no way that this was real. I have now been with Jared and Allison for 4 years, and they have given me a forever home, a roof over my head, food to eat, and a baby brother and sister, Kylie and Coton. My story will forever be one of my favorite stories. They have pushed me to be the best version of myself and have never failed to make me feel loved. They both inspire me. At 14 years old, I would have never even dreamed of graduating high school. I'm graduating with honors and will be attending the University of Kentucky and plan to be an anesthesiologist. My faith has never been so strong, and I have never felt more blessed to go through what I've told you about today. Because without these trials I've had in my life, I would not have been the person I am today. I can proudly say that my God did not fail.
So what our students taught us this song. It's a, who helped me with this? The Lingala. Who helped me? Yeah, tell me, Lingala, what is this? What language? Yeah, but tell me, where? How do you know it?
It's from the Congo.
From the Congo. So from the Congo, where they're from, they taught us this song. I tried to teach the church today, but I couldn't even do the first two words. So guys, would you come up and do it and do this for us? My God is awesome.
Yeah. For God, wait. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life.
For God did not send his Son to the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him.
Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God.
Romans 6:23. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Ephesians 2:8-9. For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourself. It is the gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast.
John 14:6. Jesus answered, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
He was despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrow and familiar with suffering.
Like one from whom men are the faces, he was despised and we esteemed not.
Surely he took up our infirmities and carried our sorrows, yet we considered him stricken by God, smitten by him, and afflicted.
But he was pierced for our transgression, he was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wound we are healed.
When the people heard this, they were cut to the heart and said to Peter and the other apostles, Brothers, what shall we do?
Peter replied, Repent and be baptized, every one of you, for the name of Jesus Christ and the forgiveness of sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit.
1 John 1:9, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness.
John 5:24, I tell you the truth, whoever hears my word and believes him who sent me his eternal life will not be condemned. He has crossed over from death to life.
2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has gone, the new has come.
Psalm 103:11-12. For as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is his love for those who fear him.
As far as the east is from the west, so far as he removed our transgressions from us.
Jesus replied, If anyone loves me, he will obey my teaching. My Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our home with him.
Jesus said,
Hey, Jim, thanks for answering your messenger. I got, yeah, he don't talk on her very often. Like I would write a message about a week later. Oh, hey, yeah, he's like, it would have never worked. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, everyone. Now, look, we have one more song. You may know this song. It's called Don't Stop Praying. No matter what you face in your life, no matter what, don't give up. Don't give up. Keep asking. Keep seeking. God will put you where you need to be if you keep asking him. But as soon as you stop asking, then that's where we're going to fail. So always keep asking. Find what he wants for you. You guys, you should be up here. You guys are singing, I can tell you. All right.
What's all impossible? I need a miracle. What's got you many in your body, single thread? What looks so hopeless now? What weighs down your heart without you? Pray for a breakthrough when the sun will break through the air. When you cry and you cry till your tears run dry, the ends of hope and you don't know why. And you wonder if you can bow your head even one more time.
North of us. All right. And he's not lying. Where they're at, it's in the middle of nowhere, basically.
Yeah.
So, man, we are so appreciative they could be here tonight, and I'm so glad that, we had y'all here. But we need to take up an offering for them because it ain't cheap getting here. You know, it takes money. So what we're going to do is, do you have one more song you could do?
Sure.
I'll have them do one more song, and then what we'll do is we'll pass around an offering plate and take up an offering for them. And are you getting that? All right. You can Venmo it to the church. We're fancy here. Like that, you know.
Yeah.
We Venmo, we Cash App, you know. We're hip here, okay? We're almost in Atlanta, so we can do those things. Yeah, if you want to give to Venmo or however you want to give, because I think, if I'm not mistaken, I think Dennis is just going to write a check to y'all. So we're going to collect the money and do that. So let's get into one more song while we pass the plate. And one thing I love about this church, doesn't matter if there's 10 of us here, there's 100 of us here, we give. This church is a giving church. And so tonight, let's you know, just show our appreciation by giving back to y'all.
All right.
I'm not sure, Miss Shane, what song do we need? Holy, 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 my heart adores you. My heart goes out to say to you, you are.
Last song got me laughed at because the running joke in our house is I sing every song whether I know the words or not. And so when it came up Spanish, she was like, go ahead, sing it. And but whoa, it was actually way better than I thought it was going to be.
So
it was good. It was good. The other thing is you may have cost us more money because Carolyn finally got to hear a banjo in the sanctuary. She's going to hear one for a while. So we may have to purchase a banjo. I don't know who's going to play it, but probably purchase one.
Leo's
so
got it.
We love the sound of a banjo. Let's stand and let's pray. Let's thank them for coming tonight. It's just wonderful to see young people in the church. You know what this reminded me of? Not everybody here's gonna know, but some of you will. Youth Musicale. I was not because I was rebellious at that age. I wanted to be, but I didn't want people to know I wanted to be. So Youth Musicale was a group that traveled and sang in the summer. They got together for a camp, and they practiced, and they went out and sang. And that's actually where your brother and my sister met, was through Youth Musicale. And I was always jealous, but we go to all the shows, and I'd listen. I think, man, I really want to be up there. But two things, I thought I was too cool, and I couldn't sing. So those two things really held me back. But we really appreciate y'all being here. It was such a great thing. It just kind of brought back some old memories when I was listening to that. So let's pray. Father, we just pray, Lord, that you would, Lord, that you would just be with them as they travel. Father, that you would put a hedge of protection around them, that you would take care of them. Father, we just thank you for the blessings that were received here tonight and your Holy Spirit was in this place. And we just pray that you'd be with each and every one of these students as they finish out the school year. Lord, just give them your love and your grace and your peace as they go on to do whatever they need to do after this year. Father, we just thank you for this time together. In your son's name we pray. Amen.
Hey, we want to thank you guys. Thank you.